sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that after the minor signs, the major signs will take place. And after the major signs, the hour will come. I ask, did you know a day will come that a child will try to behead his own father? I ask, did you know a day will come that a mother of two, she will take her daughter's Muslim, she will take her daughter's clubbing, and when she is asked, where is your husband? And she will reply by saying that he is on a taxi job. I ask, did you know a day will come that a child, the age of 11, he will return home one day and he will rape his own two little sisters and he will say, I've learned this in school. I ask, did you know a day will come that they'll have a homosexual imam and there'll be homosexuals praying behind them and they will think it's normal? I ask, did you know a day will come the father and daughter are watching a film, time passes, and they commit zina with each other? I ask, did you know a day will come that when a Muslim is told to hold the Quran in the city center, he will say, brother, my mates are watching me. Don't tell me to hold the Quran. People are going to laugh at me. The girls are going to laugh at me. And when he's told, brother, put it in your bag, he will say, I cannot take the risk. Why? Because people are watching me. So one of the brothers puts this Quran, the book of Allah, in the bag for him. And he hands it to him. And he says, brother, don't give it to me. Give it to my mate. He will carry it for me. I asked, did you know these days will come? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that time will come that people will be committing sin, and all of a sudden people's faces will be transformed into monkeys and pigs. And the same winds that destroyed the people of Lut, the same winds, the same stones will come and destroy these people. The same stones will destroy these people. The same winds that destroyed the people of Ad, the same winds will come and will destroy these people. And the earth will be open and it will take them in, and down they'll go right till the day of judgment. The day of judgment is close. But in spite of this, we brush it under the table. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that for 40 years, there'll be no iman, whether it's in Medina, whether it's in Sham, whether it's in Bosnia, whether it's in Chechnya, whether it's in Afghanistan, whether it's in Pakistan, there will be no iman. And then all of a sudden, on a Friday, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the hour will come, it will come on a Friday. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the hour will come all of a sudden without you even realizing it. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that before a transaction takes place, the hour will come. Before the person lifts a morsel to his mouth, before the morsel reaches his mouth, the hour will take place. And Allah the Almighty will order Israfil alayhi salam to blow through the horn. This angel is such that his eyes are fixed on the throne of the Creator. This angel is such that one ring of his horn is bigger than the east and west put together. This angel is such that he does not blink. Why? Fearing that he'll miss the command of Allah. And when he blows through the horn, the Himalayas, the K2, the Everest, they will come to an end. The hadith of Abu Huraira comes to mind that the earth will shake and the earth will shake in such a manner. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You will see it will be like a vessel in the middle of the ocean getting battered by tornadoes. The horn is so terrifying. Allahu Akbar. You will see. You will see a mother who's got a baby in her stomach. When she hears the horn, she will miscarry her baby. Why? Because the sound of the horn. The sound of the horn is so terrifying. That child who's only 10 years old, 15 years old, 16 years old, his face will turn wrinkly. His hair will turn white. He will look like a person who's over 100. Why? Because this is the day of reckoning.